Alléluia.
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 I'm happy to see the elders whom I saw last time, the first time I came here in Dar es
Salaam.
I see God has been so merciful to all of us. You elders, I salute you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Because of the great love which God has for us, He has permitted it once again that we may meet in this manner. I'm also happy that you have seen some elders whom I never saw the first time I came here in Dar es
Salaam.
I salute you all in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Once again, the saints of the Most High God, you are so precious in the eyes of God. Sometimes we try to undermine ourselves, thinking as if we are nothing. In the sight of God. But when you check in the Word of God, the way God treasures us, He looks to us as kings and priests. You know, a king has got a great honor. Because even the president has to respect the king. You know, kings are not depressible when they are still alive. Until when they die, that's when they will depress
them.
But the president, they will depress him even when he's alive.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Have you seen the difference between the two
here?
Where I come from in our country, we've got what they say the NRC, which is National Registration Card, where your details as to appear on that NRC.
Date of birth,
place of birth,
mahali ulipozaliwa na tarehe ulizozaliwa,
town where you were born,
mji uliozaliwa,
and the chief or the king where you come from,
na yule mkuu au mfalme kule unapotoka.
Because your king has to appear on that NRC.
Kwa sababu yule mfalme wako anapaswa aonekane kwenye hiyo kadi ya usajili wa
kitaifa. Even the president, his name as he has to indicate the king where he comes from.
Hata rais jina lake anapaswa aoneshe kwa mfalme gani ametokea.
So a king is more honorable.
Kwa hiyo mfalme anaheshimika sana.
And you are kings and priests in the sight of God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is what you should keep in your mind. You are not just an ordinary person.
Or seem to a kawaida.
You should acknowledge where you come from. Yesterday I was saying, an ambassador of the United States,
you are the Lordy wa Marekani.
When he comes here in this country, Tanzania,
anapokuja hapa katika hili taifa la Tanzania,
he has the power of the United States behind him.
Anayo nguvu za Marekani nyuma yake.
What he speaks is what comes from the United States.
Kile anachonena ni kile ambacho kimetoka huko He is a representative of that country.
Yeye ni mwakilishi wa hilo taifa.
As the prophet said, you are ambassadors of the kingdom of light.
Na nabii anasema ninyi ni mabalozi wa ufalme wa nuru.
And he said, all the angels.
Na akasema malaika wote.
All the powers in heaven.
Nguvu zote mbinguni.
They are running behind you. My mouth here has been testifying about Tanzania.
Mdomo wangu hapa umekuwa ukitoa ushuhuda kuhusu Tanzania.
I've been testifying in Zambia.
Nimekuwa nikitoa ushuhuda kule Zambia.
If God is to judge Zambia,
kama Mungu atahukumu Zambia,
then he will take the people from Tanzania.
Atachukua watu kutoka Tanzania.
And judge our country.
Na ahukumu taifa letu.
Because those people loves God more than anything.
Kwa sababu wale watu wanampenda Mungu kuliko chochote.
They come from different and far away places.
Wanatoka kutoka sehemu mbalimbali na mbali sana.
To come and hear the word of God.
Kuja na kusikia neno la Mungu.
And Jesus said,
na Mungu Yesu akasema,
the king of the south,
yule mpama, yule malkia wa kusini,
came from the uttermost part of the world.
Alitoka katika
God for.
May God bless you.
May God give you to bless. How God made the plan of
redemption.
In order for you and me to be saved. In the beginning, there was the blood of bulls and animals. I would like to take a trip to the Old Testament. Then I will come to the New Testament. Then I will enter into the mind of the prophet William
Branham.
Trying to teach the things which he taught. The reason why you and me we are gathered here. Because there's a world beyond the star. I like drinking water.
Nikasoma in First Samuel, katika Samueli wa kwanza,
chapter 28,
sura 28.
I'll start from this 7.
The other, mstari wa saba.
I've got a number of scriptures here.
Hapa nina baadhi ya maandiko hapa.
From 1 Samuel,
kuanzia Samuel wa kwanza,
I will read 1 Corinthians,
nitasoma wa Korintho wa kwanza,
which is chapter 15, verse 14-53,
ambayo ni sura 15, mstari wa 45.
The 7 says,
ndipo tuanze Samuel wa kwanza, sura 28, mstari wa 7, inasema,
then said Saul unto his servant, seek me a woman that has a familiar spirit.
Ndipo Sauli akamwambia mtumishi wake, nitafuteni mwanamke mwenye pepo wa utambuzi.
That I may go to her,
inipate kumwendea,
and inquire of her,
na kumuuliza kwake.
And his servant said to him,
na mtumishi wake akamwambia,
behold, there is a woman that has a familiar spirit at Endor.
Tazama, yuko mwanamke mwenye pepo wa utambuzi huko Endor.
And so disguised himself and put on other raiment and went.
Na Sauli akajigeuza na kuvaa mavazi mengine kisha akaenda.
And two men with him, and they came to the woman by night.
Na akaenda yeye na watu wawili pamoja naye wakamfikia yule mwanamke usiku.
And he said, I pray thee, divide unto me by the familiar spirit, and bring me him up whom I shall name.
Akasema, tafadhali unibashirie kwa utambuzi ukanipandishie yeye nitakayemtaja kwako.
And the woman said unto him,
na yule mwanamke akamwambia,
behold, thou knowest what Saul has done, how he has cut off those that have familiar spirits and wizards.
Na angalia unajua alivyofanya Sauli jinsi alivyofuatilia mbali hao wenye pepo wa utambuzi na wachawi.
Out of the land wherefore then layest thou a snare for my life to cause me to die.
Katika nchi, mbona basi wanitega tanzi uhai wangu ili kuniua?
And so swear to her by the Lord, saying, as the Lord liveth, there shall no punishment happen to thee for this thing.
Na Sauli akamwapia kwa Bwana akasema, aishivyo Bwana haitakupata adhabu yoyote kwa jambo hili.
Then said the woman, whom shall I bring up unto thee?
Ndipo yule mwanamke akasema, je, ni nani nitakaye kupandishia?
And he said, bring me up Samuel.
Naye akasema, nipandishie Samuel.
And when the woman saw Samuel, she cried with a loud voice, and the woman spoke to Saul, saying, why hast thou deceived me? For thou art Saul.
Naye yule mwanamke alipomwona Samuel alilia kwa sauti kuu. Naye yule mwanamke akamwambia Sauli akasema, mbona umenidanganya kwa kuwa wewe ndiwe Sauli?
And the king said unto her, be not afraid, for what Saul is thou?
Na mfalme akamwambia, usiogope, waona nini?
And the woman said unto Saul, I saw goats ascending out of the earth.
Yule mwanamke akamwambia Sauli, naona Mungu anatoka katika nchi.
And he said unto her, what form is he of?
Naye akamuuliza, ni mfano wa nini?
And she said, an old man cometh up, and he is covered with a mantle.
Naye akajibu, ni mzee anazuka, naye amefunikwa vazi.
And Saul perceived that it was Samuel, and he stopped with his face to the ground and bowed himself.
Basi Sauli akatambua kwamba ndiye Samueli mwenyewe. Akainama uso wake mpaka nchi akasujudia.
And Samuel said unto Saul, why hast thou disquieted me to bring me up?
Ndipo Samueli akamwambia Sauli, mbona umenitaabisha hata kunipandisha juu?
And Saul answered, I am Saul distressed, for the Philistine make war against me.
Sauli akajibu, mimi nimetaabika sana kwa kuwa hao Wafilisti wanafanya vita.
And God is departed from me and answereth me no more.
Wananifanyia vita, naye Mungu ameniacha, hanijibu tena.
Neither by prophets nor by dreams. Therefore I have called thee that thou mayest make known unto me what I shall do.
Wala kwa manabii wala kwa ndoto, kwa hiyo nimekuita ili wewe unijulishe nifanyeje.
Then said Samuel, wherefore then dost thou ask of me, since the Lord is departed from thee and is become thine enemy?
Samuel akasema, kwa nini kuniuliza mimi ikiwa Bwana amekuacha naye amekuwa adui yako?
And the Lord has done to him as he spoke by me. For the Lord has lent the kingdom out of thine hand and given it to thy neighbor, even to David.
Naye Bwana amekutendea kama alivyosema kwa kinywa changu. Bwana amekurarulia ufalme mkononi mwako na kumpa jirani yako Yaani Daudi.
Because thou obeyest not the voice of the Lord, nor executest his fierce wrath upon America, therefore as the Lord done this thing unto thee this day.
Kwa sababu wewe hukutii sauti ya Bwana, wala hukumtimilizia hasira yake kali juu ya Amaleki, kwa sababu hii Bwana amekutendea hili leo.
Moreover, the Lord will also deliver Israel with thee unto the hand of the Philistine, and tomorrow shall thou and thy son be with me. Amen. The Lord also shall deliver the host of Israel unto the hand of the Philistine.
Tena pamoja na wewe Bwana atawatia Israeli mkononi mwa Wafilisti. Hata kesho wewe na mwanao mtakuwa pamoja nami. Tena Bwana atawatia jeshi la Israeli pia mkononi mwa Wafilisti.
In 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 14.
Katika Wakorintho wa kwanza sura ya 15 mstari wa 40.
I'm getting my subheading from this First Corinthians.
Napata kichwa changu cha somo kidogo kutoka katika Wakorintho wa kwanza hii.
From this spot here, that's where I'm getting my title of the message.
There are also celestial bodies and bodies celestial, but the glory of the celestial is one and the glory of the celestial is another.
Tena kuna miili ya mbinguni na miili ya duniani. Lakini fahari yake ile ya mbinguni ni mbali na fahari yake ile ya duniani ni mbali.
There is one glory of the sun and another glory of the moon.
Tena kuna fahari au utukufu moja ya jua na fahari nyingine ya mwezi.
And another glory of the stars, for another star different from another star in glory.
Na fahari nyingine ya nyota, maana iko tofauti ya fahari hata kati ya nyota na nyota.
So also is the resurrection of the dead, it is sown in corruption, it is raised in incorruption.
Kadhalika na kiama ya watu upanda katika uharibifu kufufuliwa katika kutokuharibika.
It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power.
Upandwa katika aibu kufufuliwa katika fahari. Upandwa katika udhaifu kufufuliwa katika nguvu.
It is sown in a natural body, it is raised in a spiritual body.
Upandwa mwili wa asili kufufuliwa mwili wa roho.
There is a natural body and there is a spiritual body.
Ikiwa uko mwili wa asili na wa roho uko pia.
And so it is written, the first man Adam was made a living soul, the last Adam was made a quickening spirit.
Ndivyo ilivyoandikwa, mtu wa kwanza Adam akawa nafsi iliyo hai, Adamu wa mwisho ni roho yenye kuhuisha.
Howbeit that was not first which is spiritual, but that which is natural.
Lakini atuugulii ule wa roho, bali ule wa asili, baadaye kuja ule wa roho.
And afterward that which is spiritual.
Okay. Lakini hautangulii ule wa roho, bali ule wa asili, na baadaye kuja ule wa roho.
The first man is of the earth, earthly, the second man is the Lord from heaven.
Mtu wa kwanza atoka katika nchi ni wa udongo. Mtu wa pili atoka mbinguni ni Bwana kutoka mbinguni.
As is the earth, such are they also that are earthly.
Kama alivyo yeye wa udongo, ndivyo walivyo wa udongo.
And as is the heavenly, such are they also that are heavenly.
Kama alivyo yeye wa mbinguni, ndivyo walivyo walio mbinguni.
And as we are born the image of the earth,
na kama tunavyochukua sura ya yake yule wa udongo,
we shall also bear the image of the heavenly.
Tutachukua sura yake yeye aliye wa mbinguni.
Shall we pray?
Na tuombe.
Our God and our Father.
Baba yetu na Mungu wetu.
I commit this word of God into your hand.
Nalikabidhi neno hili mikononi mwako.
For the Bible says no scripture is of private interpretation.
Kwa sababu Biblia inasema hakuna andiko linalofasiriwa apendavyo mtu.
I'm just a human being, Lord.
Mimi ni mwanadamu tu, Bwana.
Born in sins, shaped in iniquity, come to this world speaking lies.
Nimezaliwa katika dhambi nikatungwa mimba katika uovu nikaja duniani nikisema uongo.
But saved by grace.
Lakini ninaokolewa kwa neema.
Come and honor the word which I speak.
Njoo uheshimu lile neno nitakalolinena.
The Bible says let every man's word be a liar.
Biblia inasema hebu kila neno la mwanadamu liwe uongo.
And your word be true always.
Na lile neno lako liwe kweli mara zote.
Open our understanding that we may understand the scriptures.
Tufungulie ufahamu wetu tuweze kuelewa maandiko.
I pray, Father, that the power of the Most High God may come upon the sense of the living God.
Ninaomba kwamba nguvu ya Mungu aliye juu sana ije juu ya watakatifu wa Bwana aishie.
Those that are not feeling alright this evening,
wale ambao hawajisikii vizuri jioni hii,
grant them strength and power in their bodies in Jesus' name.
Wajalie nguvu na uweza katika miili yao kwa jina la Yesu Kristo.
You are the only creator of the universe.
Wewe ndiye muumba ulimwengu pekee.
Whatever is missing in their
body for the goodness of the kingdom of God created in Jesus' name.
Lolote linalokosekana katika mili yao kwa ajili ya uzuri wa Mungu liumbe kwa jina la Yesu.
I grant them complete healing in Jesus' name.
Ninawaombea uponyaji kamilifu katika jina la Yesu.
I pray that you are the only healer, Jehovah our Rapha.
Naomba kwamba wewe uponyaji pekee Jehovah Rapha.
You were in this world healing all manner of diseases and all manner of sickness.
Ulikuwepo hapa ulimwenguni ukiponya kila aina ya ugonjwa na kila aina ya mateso.
Even today and the same yesterday, today and forever.
Hata leo wewe ni yule jana leo na hata milele.
What you did those days you can do it today.
Kile ulichofanya siku hizo unaweza kukifanya leo.
I declare that healing power.
Ninatangaza hiyo nguvu ya
uponyaji. I grant to them your sense of the living God in Jesus' name.
Ninawapeni ninyi watakatifu wa Mungu aishie katika jina la Yesu.
May you receive your healing in Jesus' name.
Pokeeni uponyaji wenu katika jina la Yesu.
I pray. Amen.
Amen.
God richly bless you. You may be seated.
Mungu awabariki kwa wingi, mnaweza kuketi.
Our name, our subject today,
italika somo letu leo,
the three different bodies,
mili tatu tofauti,
the three separate bodies,
mili tatu tofauti.
These bodies, there's a celestial body,
hii mili kuna ule mwili wa kimbinguni.
And there's also a body celestial.
Na kuna miili ya duniani.
There's also a glorified body.
Na kuna mwili uliotukuzwa.
But between the celestial and the celestial body, you must possess one.
Kati ya ule mwili wa kimbinguni na mwili wa kidunia, lazima umiliki mmoja wako.
But these three bodies,
lakini hii miili mitatu,
the first is a natural called the mortal body.
Na ule wa kwanza ni wa kimwili wa kawaida ambao unaitwa mwili wa duniani.
Then the second is either a celestial or a celestial body.
Na huu mwingine ni wa kimbinguni.
And the last one is called the glorified body.
Na huu wa mwisho unaitwa mwili uliotukuzwa.
The Bible tells us.
Biblia inatuambia.
In the beginning,
hapo mwanzo,
God created a man in his own image.
Mungu aliumba mtu kwa sura yake.
And he created a man male and female in his own image.
Na aliumba mtu mwanaume na mwanamke kwa sura yake.
He created.
Aliumba.
He spoke the word.
Alinena neno.
And man and woman became into existence.
Na mwanaume na mwanamke wakatokea.
On the same day,
siku hiyo hiyo,
God created them in a spiritual realm.
Mungu aliwaumba katika hali ya kiroho.
Brother Branham said he created them in a theophany because God was in a theophany.
Ndugu Branham anasema aliwaumba katika theophania maana Mungu alikuwa katika theophania.
And they were leading animals in a spiritual realm.
Na walikuwa wakiongoza wanyama katika hali ya kiroho.
Just like the Holy Ghost leads a believer today.
Kama tu Roho Mtakatifu anavyomuongoza mwaminio leo.
We don't see the Holy Ghost.
Hatuoni Roho Mtakatifu.
But we are led by the Holy Ghost.
Lakini tunaongozwa na Roho Mtakatifu.
They asked Jesus.
Walimuuliza Yesu.
In Luke chapter 17 verse 20.
Katika Luka sura 17 mstari wa 20.
When is the kingdom of God going to come?
Lini ufalme wa Mungu utakuja?
Because the kingdom of God is the Holy Ghost.
Kwa sababu ufalme wa Mungu ni Roho Mtakatifu.
The kingdom of God does not come with observation.
Ufalme wa Mungu hauji kwa kuchunguza kutazama.
You cannot say there it is or oh, here it is.
Huwezi ukasema iko pale au iko hapa.
For the kingdom of God is within you.
Kwa sababu ufalme wa Mungu upo ndani yenu.
So God created the man and the woman in a spiritual form.
Kwa hiyo Mungu aliumba mwanamke na mwanaume katika hali ya kiroho.
They were there in existence.
Walikuwa pale katika kutokea kwao.
And the animals were there in existence.
Na wanyama walikuwa pale katika uwepo.
Adam was a man.
Eli
leading the animals was a man.
Yule kiongozi alikuwa kiongozi wa wanyama alikuwa
leading them in a spiritual form. Because God created a man, male and female. He created them. Wow, they were in the image of God. So the first creation was the image of God. And that image of God is the spiritual image. So a man was in the spiritual form. And in Genesis chapter 2, from verse 7, and the Bible says, God formed man.
Mungu akamfanya mtu.
God did not create.
Mungu hakuumba.
He already created in Genesis chapter 1:26.
Alikuwa ametauka katika Mwanzo 1:26.
Now God was forming man.
Sasa Mungu alikuwa akifinyanga sasa
alitoa the 16 different elements of the world.
Akachukua elementi 16 tofauti tofauti.
From the cash and potash, petroleum, cosmetic, life. God did not said,
Mungu akusema,
I will make him a servant made for him.
Hakusema nitakufanyia mtu kwa mwanza
wa ajili yake. Said, I will help make for him.
Alisema msaidizi wake.
Who fight besides the Holy Ghost?
Mwanamke pembeni ya Roho. Ukiacha Roho Mtakatifu,
the best gift God gave to a man was a woman.
Na aun mwanaume anapata mwanamke him.
He prophesied about the going away of Israel. Every spiritual man is beside their burial place.
Because when the wife was formed,
kwa sababu yule mke alipotengenezwa,
Hakikuanzia hapa.
They are the place where they started from.
Kuna mahali tulianzia.
They started right there.
Tulianza kule kule.
This fighting we see.
Huku kupigana tunapokuona.
Even if we read the message.
Hata hapa ndani ya ujumbe.
When you see the hatred amongst the brethren.
Ukiona chuki kati ya ndugu.
You know where they got it from.
Unajua walipata hiyo.
When you see the jealousy.
Unapata wivu.
You know is the originator of all those things.
Unajua yeye aliyeanzisha haya mambo.
They are where they came from.
Kuna mahali nilitoka.
Anything which at the beginning. Way.
Yeah.
To repent.
the earth.
Na Biblia inasema wale watu waliokuwa ole wenu naoishi duniani.
Because Satan has fallen there.
Ni kwa sababu Shetani ameangukia hapo.
And God said, I will go down by myself.
Amen.
No man could finish what came from heaven.
Amen.
And it came, he came in the form of a human being. The prophet said, the first creation, God created a man in his own image.
Mungu aliumba mtu kwa sura yake.
So God created a man in the image of God in the spirit.
Mungu aliumba mwanadamu kwa sura yake katika roho.
Then God created himself in the image of a man.
Ndipo Mungu akajiumba mwenyewe katika sura ya mwanadamu.
That's what he did.
Sivyo ndivyo alivyofanya.
Was to come in the form of a human being. In the book of Philippians chapter
2,
on verse 5 says, let the mind which was in Christ Jesus be in you. If being found in a fashion as a man, he was just found in a fashion as a man. He wasn't a man, but he became a man. And he humbled himself to the death of the cross. He came from somewhere. He was not a man, but he made himself in the likeness like a man. Because sin was committed in this mortal body, he had to come covering himself with a body again.
Amen.
So that he can relate with a human being. He can feel what a human being feels.
Yes.
Even when he covered himself with a body, he came with two parts. He was both man and God. He was both man and God. The other part was a human being. A full human being. He was feeling hungry the way we do. He was getting tired the way we do. He could sleep in a mountain the way we do. But when he speaks, that was God speaking. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
See what he did to Lazarus. When he went to Lazarus, we are told that Lazarus, when he was sick, Jesus said,
yes, you are the same.
Our friend Lazarus is sick. And Jesus could not go. Because Jesus could not do anything outside the will of God. Everything he did was in line with the will of God. If you remember in the prayer, he taught his disciples, pray in this manner. Our Father who art in heaven,
hallowed
be thy name, thy kingdom come, the Holy Ghost come, and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. You know, when the kingdom of God come upon a man, is a different man. Not do his own will now. Because the kingdom has come. He has to do the will of God on
it is in heaven.
Thank you.
Yeah. Brother, in the message called the demonology,
katika ujumbe unaoitwa elimu juu ya pepo,
here. The first trinity of hell. What is there? The first one is the religion of the lost. That's why I said when you die, we are looking at the three different bodies. First, we are in a human form here. This is a mortal body. Where you and me, we are servant of hunger. Something must die for something to have life. Then in the supernatural realm, someone had to die in order for us to have eternal life. So when we come out of this body, William Branham will explain here. But let me just explain before William Branham comes in. When we die, we are not finished. We must exist somewhere. Death does not change us. It only changes the dwelling place. William Branham is saying, when Samuel died,
William Branham anasema wakati Samuel amekufa,
he died as a prophet.
Alikufa kama nabii.
Even when he was resurrected,
na hata alipofufuka,
he was still a prophet.
Alikuwa bado nabii.
He told his soul exactly what must come to pass.
Alimweleza Sauli hasa kile kinapaswa kutendeka.
Nothing changed.
Hakuna kitu kilibadilika.
Only the dwelling place.
Ni mahali tu pa kuishi.
So there is a religion of the lost.
Kwa kuna mahali pa waliopotea.
When we die,
tunapokufa,
if I die as a sinner,
kama nikifa kama mwenye dhambi,
I enter into a celestial body.
Ninaingia katika mwili wa kidunia hapa.
Soil shall go to the soil.
Kwa ule mavumbi ataenda kwenye mavumbi.
This body goes to the soil. And the spirit goes back to God who gave it.
Na roho inarudi kwa Mungu aliyeitoa.
But remember, I have the soul.
Lakini kumbuka ninayo nafsi.
Ezekiel chapter 18 verse 4 says, all living souls are mine.
Ezekiel inasema, nafsi zote zinazoishi ni za kwangu.
The soul of the son as well as the father, they are mine.
Nafsi ya baba na ya mwana yote ni ya kwangu.
The soul that dies, that sins shall die. So my soul has got a body
in our will
in a celestial and goes to the religion of the lost. So the religion of the lost is the bottomless. A place full of darkness and torment. There's no peace there. I am there feeling the pain. In that body called the celestial. So from the celestial, from the religion of the lost, then there's what is called the realm of demons. That's what William Branham is saying in the message, demonology. Those realms of demons, they are the one who comes to hell to torment the souls of the unbelievers.
Sins
once for the just and the unjust.
Yes, aliteseka kwa dhambi mara moja kwa ajili ya mwenye haki na asiye haki.
That might take us to God.
Ili kwamba atuleteshe kwa Mungu.
Being put to death in the flesh.
Akiwekwa katika hali ya kufa katika mwili.
And justified in the spirit.
Na kuhesabiwa haki katika roho.
So the soul, because it can't be the sins of the world.
So kwa sababu ile nafsi, kwa sababu ni mbeba dhambi za ulimwengu.
Remember 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 21 says,
kumbuka no see. Kumbuka Wakorintho wa pili sura ya 5 nasema yeye hakutua dhambi.
Yet he became sin for the sake of us.
Hata yule akafanyika dhambi kwa ajili yetu.
So there was an exchange.
Kwa kulikuwa na kubadilishana.
He was the sin of the world.
Akapata dhambi ya ulimwengu.
Because every sinner must go to hell.
Kwa sababu kila mtu dhambi lazima aende kuzimu.
So when you go to the sin of the world on the cross.
Sinner,
and God who is the spirit come out of that body.
Ndipo
eyes, my brother. They were singing the mighty conqueror. Then when he knocked,
Abraham opened.
And when he opened, then he called Sarah.
Sarah,
come and see the man.
Sarah, go what you want to do.
The man was sitting under the tree. And he gave us the promise of Isaac. It is now getting dawn.
Sasa, you must be a kikoma cha
leo. Oh, we must go.
So, pasa tuende.
And he entered the paradise.
Na askari, akaifanya tupu paradiso. And Abraham said, na Ibrahim akasema.
Lord, are we going to stop over?
Akasema, je, Mungu, tutakwenda kusimama kidogo.
I want to see a glimpse of old Jerusalem.
Nataka nione. Kwani kale wa Jerusalem.
You see, when they came out,
unaona walipotoka nje,
they appeared unto many.
Walipotokea wengi,
and they were in Jerusalem for 40 days.
Walikuwa Jerusalem kwa siku 40.
They were moving up and down.
Walikuwa kitembea chini na juu.
The priest could see people coming in and disappear. Because the supreme sacrifice was provided. There was no need for them to remain in paradise. And paradise was empty. And now they started their journey into the third heaven. They went far beyond the moon. Far beyond the sun. The prophet says there was a commemoration in the sky. Angels were there with the band singing. This same Jesus whom you have seen, he will come the same way you have seen him going. The prophet is saying, when they delivered the message, they said, brother, let's join the procession there. They went up to join the procession going into the realm of peace. They were going into heaven. Hallelujah. You see, brother. You see, my sister. What you are here is a reflection of what you shall be there. Let's read what the prophet is saying here in the message, question and answers. This is
540103.
540103. Paragraph 77.
Paragraph 77.
I'll start from 78.
Let me start from 7:7. Now notice then when they were captured and carried away into Babylon. Because they tried to impersonate the nations of the world. What a beautiful picture today of the church trying to impersonate the world out yonder. And carried away with their living. Israel was impersonating Babylon. The church is impersonating the world. So this is the danger of impersonating what the world is doing. The church lives just the same as the world does. You know, we are supposed to be unique, different from the world. But when we try to copy the world, it becomes our standard, then we are in trouble. That is on act just like it. And everything else and claiming to be the church. You can't do that. No, sir. Your very life proves what you are. So your life proves what you are. You shall be known by your fruits. There are no two ways about it. Salvation for you to be saved, it's here on earth. There is nothing to say maybe in heaven something will happen, you know. 78 says, what you are,
here
as I said in the beginning, what you are somewhere else, is what you reflect here. If you don't love God here, the other man there doesn't love God. Remember, we have three separate bodies. Either you have a celestial or a celestial body, which is a theophan. Before coming here, we left a body somewhere. So your reflection here is the reflection of that body somewhere. And there are two destinations. No two ways about it. What you are here, that's what you shall receive in the other body. What you are, what your celestial or celestial body is up yonder,
celestial.
So you see, either you are in a celestial body, oh, you are in a selection which is a pure
family.
So your own being here is telling you who you are there. Salvation is an individual affair. These preachers here,
how will be?
They are just trying to help you. To do you a favor. If you want, you can decide to be the way you want to be. You have the power of decision. To decide to be a better person or to be a useless person. But remember, we shall all come to the end of our Lord. When we shall close our eyes in death, then we have to face an angry God.
But whilst we are still alive, it's never too late. Listen to what he said. What your celestial body is somewhere else is what you are reflecting back here. Not this body. This is a mortal body. It will die. And the soil to the soil. Dust to the dust. Now your soul. Where will you spend your eternity? Better make a decision now. There are no two ways about it. Yes, we can be respected here. But God is no respecter of persons. That's why he left the throne to come and die for the sins of the world. He is an angry God. We can't play around with him. In the spirit land, what you are is what you are here. If you are true, vigor minded, and so forth, in the spirit, land, you are vigor minded here. If you still got malice, envy, and strife, you are in the spirit land with that. It reflects back here. But if your whole innermost being has become cleansed and purged, that you have got a body out yonder waiting, that's been cleansed and purged, it's reacting back in the flesh. Don't you see? See, there it is. If this earthly tabernacle be dissolved, we have one already waiting. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
What a promise! Amen. Satan has not promised anybody.
Shetani hajamwahidi yoyote.
Do we have anywhere where Satan says, where I'll be, thou shalt be there also? No way. So meaning Satan is just a fool.
No,
why should we believe Satan if he has no promise? It's better you and me, we hold it to the promise. Even me, my brother here. Even as I came here, I have no kingdom today. I can assure you, you people trying to follow the Gaelians, trying to follow this and that.
Now then,
you better be very careful. And the people with money, they are misleading the poor.
Now, what want to the pesa, when our mother be buyer, when we must kill.
Brother Branham says it's better for me to eat crackers, drink bright water, and wear overalls and remain in the No matter how known or how
going to die. Follow the original way. What I preach here, if you do not see it in the way, follow me.
Nifuate.
Come to me. Come. Come and show me. That's why I try to be very careful. Because I'll be judged over the things I'm speaking to
you.
That's why it's better I hide in the prophet William Branham. Remember yesterday I said, you know, some of you, you may not know where you're going. Let me give you a leakage. Do you want a leakage? You know someone who has a leakage and the other one who doesn't jump. That one who has a leakage will pass because he already knows what is coming.
na alikwenda mbinguni mara mbili.
The first time he went to heaven,
mara ya kwanza alikwenda mbinguni,
it was the time when the first wife of God.
Ni wakati ambapo mke wake wa kwanza alifariki.
William ndo anamumezi the little Sharon in glory.
Na William brother wakukutana na yule Sharon mdogo kule kutukufuni.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Where brother Branham was living in his chair in glory.
Wakati mke wake alikuwa akitembea kwenye kitanda kule kutukufuni.
And the second time,
na mara ya pili,
the angel came saying, would you like to see at the other side of the river?
Na Maria akaja na kumwambia uje upende kuona upande wa pili wa mto.
That time was laying down at his bed on his pillow.
Wakati alikuwa amelala katika kitanda chake na mto nyuma ya kitanda chake.
And it started moving.
Na akaanza kwenda.
When he looked back,
alipotazama nyuma,
he saw an old body laying on the bed.
Akaona mwili wake mzee ulala.
Where he was,
lakini kule alipokuwa,
he was a young man and dead.
Alikuwa kijana tena.
So the angel as sin was
blessed.
And this man at the God who is the Lord Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ declared truly Elijah must be first God.
And Jesus Christ
mwaka 57 mwezi wa 6
57:10:06.
Mwaka 57 mwezi wa 10 tarehe 6.
57:10:06. We'll start from paragraph
839.
The prophet says,
Nabiya nasema,
but when you are born again,
wakati mzaliwa upya,
then the light of God shines down into that soul.
Ndipo nuru ya Mungu inaangaza chini kwenye hiyo nafsi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then it's no more a dark valley.
Ndipo si bonde lenye giza tena.
But it's a valley with a shadow in it.
Lakini ni bonde lenye kivuli ndani yake.
You may be veiled here with the flesh, just as we have the body here.
Unaweza ukawa umetiwa vuli katika mwili kama tulivyona mimi hapa.
And the things of our face.
Na mambo juu ya nyuso zetu.
But there is enough light in there.
Lakini iko nuru ya kutosha kule.
And someday that light and darkness has to separate.
Na siku moja hiyo nuru na giza zinapaswa kutengana.
And when the light shines, darkness flees.
Na wakati nuru inaangaza, giza linatiwa ganzi.
So you know when this light comes, darkness runs away.
Unajua nuru inapokuja, giza inakimbia.
You cannot live in light and in darkness at the same time.
Wewe unaishi katika nuru na giza wakati mmoja.
So you must possess one.
Kwa lazima umiliki moja au uwe na moja.
And when we go to be with Christ in that body, in that celestial body, darkness and death vanishes. And we must burst out into perfect light. Glory to God. There we are, no more sickness.
Hapo ndipo tulitakapokuwa, hakuna tena magonjwa.
No more dark mixed with it.
Hakuna tena giza ikichanganyikana pamoja nayo.
Light now we have both sickness and joy.
Hata sasa tunao yote magonjwa na furaha.
And we have healthy and strength.
Na tuna afya na nguvu.
And we have ins and out.
Na tuna vya ndani na vya nje.
And ups and down.
Kuingia na kutoka, juu na chini.
And joy and sorrow suffer.
Na uzuni na kadhalika.
Well, it's just a shadow.
Vema ni kivuli tu.
We got enough light to know that there is light there.
Tunao nuru ya kutosha kujua kwamba kuna nuru kule.
So there's light where we are going.
Kwa ipo nuru kule tunakokwenda.
That's why we've got enough light here.
Ndio maana tuna nuru ya kutosha hapa.
And we are still in the body.
Na bado tu katika mwili.
In the flesh.
Katika mwili.
But someday,
lakini siku moja,
the day is going to break.
Siku inakwenda kufika.
That's when the death angel sits at the foot of the bed.
Hapo ndipo yule malaika wa kifo ataketi katika miguu ya kitanda.
There's an angel of death.
Yupo malaika wa kifo.
He's going to come at your foot.
Atakuja katika miguu yako.
You are laying down.
Unalala pale.
You've got a relative on your head, bedside.
Uko na ndugu yako kichwani kwako.
At your leg here.
Na hapa kwenye miguu yako malaika wa kifo amekuja.
To tell you it's time up.
Atakukwambia sasa ni wakati.
And we shall not learn when.
Na hatuta epuka.
That's where everyone now should fear.
Hapo ndipo kila mmoja anapaswa kuogopa.
Whether you are a believer or non-believer, that angel will appear.
Hata ikajalishi kama wewe aaminie au asiamini, huyo malaika atakutokea.
So before that angel appears,
kwa kabla huyo malaika hajatokea,
you have to come. And make your confession before the
altar. Unapaswa uje na ufanye ukiri wako mbele ya madhabahu.
That's when the doctor says it's all finished.
And this natural comes away from the supernatural. And the light springs back to light. And darkness goes back to darkness. Then this mortal puts on immortality. That's when this corruption puts on incorruption. That's when this motto puts on immortality. And we become from a creature of time to a creature of
eternity.
You cannot go out there with total darkness. You have got to have light in the darkness. There you are, that's the body you receive. What do we do? Well, my dear sainted brother, my dear sainted sister, before the foundation of the world, when God created you in his image, or created the man in his image and created the woman in the image of the man, for the glory of the man, he made you a theophan. Just like himself. When he said, "Let us," to the creature that he had made, "Let us make man in our own image, in our own likeness, a theophan." God had never become flesh yet. He was in a theophan. Before he was in the flesh, he was in a theophan. That's why he was visiting Adam and Eva every day. Now, as I am closing, I've got so many quotations I can read here. I have them written here in adoption number 2, paragraph 68 to 8. The identified masterpiece of God at Kadesh Barnea, making a way. These are the quotations, there are so many of them talking about the three separate bodies. So the first body is a human body. This is the human body where we commit sin in. That's why Jesus said you must be born again. Then we have a celestial body. I'm saying celestial because you are believers here. A theophan body somewhere. So you are seated here. That body is seated in heaven. It is listening to the word of God. There is no difference. Your body, natural body, is sitting, but your spiritual body is also seated in heaven. So that body has gone to the realm of peace. That body is seated in heaven. So that body has gone to the realm of peace.
Paradiso
is there. It's not over here. Jesus lifted it, took it to the sixth dimension. There are so many sections there. You know, the seventh dimension is the throne of God. But the sixth dimension has got so many
Paulo.
When William Branham went to that team, he asked, I want to see Paul.
Wakati William Branham ameenda katika kile kilabu, aliuliza anataka kuona Paulo.
They told him it's somewhere with the other people.
Yuko sehemu nyingine na watu wengine.
Irenaeus is somewhere.
Irenaeus yuko pale pengine.
Martin is somewhere.
Martin yuko pengine.
Columba is somewhere.
Columba yuko pengine.
Luther is somewhere.
Luther yuko pengine.
The only door,
mlango pekee,
which is still open,
ambao bado uko wazi,
that door,
ni dhati ya mlango.
Message entitled Disappointment at the Judgment.
Wakati unaokuwa kanena kuhusu ujumbe unaitwa kuhuzunishwa katika hukumu, kufadhaika katika hukumu.
Oh, come and see what kind of people will be disappointed at the judgment.
Utakuja kuona ni watu gani watakuwa wamefadhaika katika siku ya hukumu.
William Branham has spoken those things here.
William Branham amenena mambo hayo hapa.
So that you and me, we should not be part of those people who shall be disappointed.
Ili kwamba wewe na mimi tusiwe sehemu ya wale watu watakaovunjwa moyo wakati ule.
God richly bless you.
Amen.